bonds are we gonna see?
Bonds.
What kind of bonds are we gonna see?
Bonds.
So what kind of bonds are you gonna see?
Bonds.
Take two items and compare electronegativities.
Bonds.
So what kind of bonds are you gonna see? Take two items and compare electronegativities.
Which of the three bonds depends on the strength of the electronegativity of the atoms?
Take the smallest number and subtract it from the largest. If it's higher than 1.7, then the bond is called ionic.
So what if the difference is smaller than 1.7? Call it polar covalent. That's because electrons are shed between atoms in orbit of each other valence.
But one atom pulls harder, the one more electronegative. You see this in water, where oxygen is partly negative.
So what kind of bonds are you gonna see? Take two items and compare electronegativities.
Nonpolar bonds can form between two atoms of the same element. In this case, there's no electronegativity difference. Don't be fooled by my lyrics, I'm just trying to rhyme. Nonpolar bonds can form between two non-metals sometimes. Metallic bonds, a sea of electrons, form between two metals that will not conduct a charge. Because the things that move are the electrons, dude, we call this movement current of electrons passing through.
So what kind of bonds are you gonna see? Take two items and compare electronegativities. So what kind of bonds are you gonna see? Take two items and compare electronegativities.